Hello everyone, welcome back to this series called Finance Current Affairs, where we pick up some important financial topics and we try and discuss them with the help of different questions. So before moving on to the first question, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, then please do subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can be notified about all our upcoming videos. If you are looking forward to the free PDFs of these sessions, then you will be getting those PDFs through the Telegram group. You can join this group, the link is in the description below. So let's move on to the first question now. It says, which of the following services are provided by the International Financial Services Center? So let's first discuss about International Financial Services Center, what's the latest news about it, and then we'll come back to this question. So recently, what happened is that a committee was formulated in order to provide the advices on enhancing the working of these International Financial Services Center to develop them specifically with respect to the insurance. So IFSCA, that is the International Financial Services Center Authority, with an objective to develop the financial products and the services, the International Financial Services Center constituted an insurance committee. Under whose chairmanship? Under the chairmanship of Mr. G.N. Bajpayee, former chairman of LIC and SEBI. So this committee was formulated and it was by under the chairmanship of Mr. G.N. Bajpayee, and this committee has made certain recommendations on how we can enhance the working of the International Financial Service Center, how we can better develop different financial products and services. So specifically, an insurance committee was formulated to enhance the working of the insurance part of these IFSCs. So what are IFSCs? What is an International Financial Service Center? See, there is a body which was established by the government, the IFSCA, that is the International Financial Service Authority, which regulates and develops these IFSCs. So jitne bhi ye International Financial Service Centers hai, inka development aur inka regulation kaun karta hai? Wo karta hai ek body jiska naam hai International Financial Services Authority. Ab hum baat karenge ki International Financial Services Center kya hai. So it is a financial center that caters to the customers outside the jurisdiction of domestic economy. Now there are many investors who are the investors beyond our geographical boundaries, not in the domestic economy. Those international investors also want to invest. Okay, so this financial center will provide them with the opportunities of investment. It will cater to those customers who are looking forward to go international, to access different financial products, services internationally, to raise funding internationally. So it's a financial service financial center that caters to the customers outside your domestic economy. It is also known as offshore financial center because it deals in the flow of finance, financial products and services across borders. So beyond borders, ye dusri country ke logo ko financial products, services, finance ki facilities offer karte hain. An IFSC is thus a jurisdiction that provides world-class financial services to the non-residents and residents to the extent permissible under current regulations in a currency other than domestic currency of the location where IFSC is located. So international investors can invest, they can raise funding, they can get access to different financial services in different foreign currencies, not just because this center is in India, so it will provide the services in rupees. No, in international currencies also it will offer the services. So IFSC facilitates the rerouting of financial services and transactions currently carried out in the offshore financial centers by Indian corporates and overseas branches to India. Now there are various entities in India which provide financial products and services. If they want to provide these services to the international clients, what they used to do? They used to set their branches in international countries. Basically, they used to set their branches internationally in different countries, or they used to set up their subsidies. Now what is happening? Now this IFSC can be set up in India. These entities, despite of being having a physical entity in India, they can provide the access to these services to the international clients. So pehle agar aapko international clients ko ye services offer karni hoti thi, to aapko apni entity ki ek branch, ek subsidiary dusri country mein kholni padti thi. Ab kya hai ki aap apni country mein hi center set karo aur international clients directly financial product services khareed payenge. the business and regulatory environment offered by IFSC in India would be comparable to that of London, New York to attract the investors. So it's as the name suggests, it's an international financial services center. So it's going to offer the services to the international clients. The international level services will be offered, the kind of environment which is there in, say, London, New York or other major nation, that kind of an environment will be offered in this center, that kind of services they will be offering to the international clients. So, inka level of service offering internationally, aap compare kar sakte ho, badi-badi countries se milta julta hai and international clients ko hi cater karenge. Now, talking about what types of services does this IFSC provides. So, IFSC provides the option of fundraising for different corporations, individuals, government, okay, the asset management, wealth management, risk management. So, insurance, reinsurance options we offer karta hai, mergers, acquisitions between transnational corporations. So, these kinds of services are offered by the International Financial Service Center. Ye ek center hai jo international level ka environment provide karta hai beyond domestic boundaries jo investors hai unke liye ya waise customers jinhe alag alag type ki services ki zarurat hai like these mentioned over here. Moving ahead now, this committee was set up in order to focus on the areas of development of the insurance and reinsurance business. So the committee, after various consultations, studies, in-depth discussions, it has come up with some recommendations, and those recommendations will help in developing IFSC as a global insurance hub. So let's discuss few of those recommendations. So is committee ne kuch recommendations di hai jisse ki hum IFSC ko ek global insurance hub bana sakte hai. Why I'm discussing these very recommendations? Because there are few important terms used over here, which are quite useful for you being a person applying for any kind of exam which deals in the financial part. Okay, finance ke student ke liye terms jana zaruri hai. There are various terms like captive insurance, catastrophe bonds. So you should be aware about these. That's why I've picked up this very set of recommendations. Isme kuch achhi important terms hai jo ek finance ke students ko pata honi chahiye. So what are the recommendations? One is that IFSC has developed an ecosystem for aircraft leasing and financing. So it will be utilized to develop your aviation insurance hub and trade credit insurance. So insurance ko develop karne mein ye help karega jo aircraft leasing and financing ecosystem IFSC ne develop kiya hai. Next is the captive insurance model is one of the cost efficient manner of managing own risk. Khud ki risk se protect karne ke liye khud ko ya cost effective manner mein us risk se saath deal karne ke liye us risk ko manage karne ke liye captive insurance model is really very useful. Okay, globally leading financial centers have favorable regulatory regime for the captive insurance model. So this very committee has recommended that IFSCA may develop a new framework to enable the operations of captives. So captive insurance mein ye focus kare IFSCA, ye ek recommendation hai. What is captive insurance? See, insurance companies offer different types of insurance, different types of protection to the ones who are taking the insurance. But by doing so, the insurance company is also taking a lot of risk. Okay, it might also need some kind of insurance at times. So, instead of taking that insurance from some other company, what the insurance company can do? It can set up its own licensed company, its own subsidiary, which will be providing the insurance to the insurance company. That is captive insurance. आप अपनी खुद की एक company बना लो, insurance company बना लो, या अपनी company की subsidiary बना लो, जो आपको ही insurance देगी, आपकी risk protect करेगी, जिससे कि आपको दूसरी insurance company में depend होने की जरूरत नहीं है. That is captive insurance. Captive insurance company is a wholly owned subsidiary insurer that provides risk mitigation services for its parent company or a group of companies. अपनी ही पेरेंट कंपनी को जो इंश्योरेंस देती है, रिस्क मिटिगेशन सर्विसेज देती है, वो होती है कैप्टिव इंश्योरेंस कंपनी. आप अपनी खुद की एक कंपनी बना लो इंश्योरेंस प्रोवाइड करने के लिए आपको. अ कैप्टिव इंश्योरेंस कंपनी मे बी फॉर्म्ड फॉर वेरियस रीजंस लाइक द पेरेंट कंपनी कैन नॉट फाइंड अ सूटेबल आउटसाइड फर्म टू इंश्योर देम अगेंस्ट पर्टिकुलर रिस्क. आपको किसी पर्टिकुलर टाइप की रिस्क से प्रोटेक्शन चाहिए जो कोई और इंश्योरेंस कंपनी प्रोवाइड नहीं कर रही, तो आप अपनी खुद की कंपनी बना लो और ये सर्विस अपने आपको प्रोवाइड करा लो. If the premium paid to the captive insurer create tax savings, or if the insurance provider is more affordable, प्रोवाइडेड इज मोर अफोर्डेबल. आप दूसरे पे डिपेंड करोगे वो आपको ज्यादा महंगी इंश्योरेंस देगा, ज्यादा प्रीमियम्स आपको पे करने पड़ेंगे, तो आप अपनी खुद की एंटिटी सेट कर सकते हो. और इट ऑफर्स बेटर कवरेज फॉर द पेरेंट कंपनी रिस्क. आपकी रिस्क ऐसी है कि आपको खुद को ही सेट करनी पड़ रही है एक अलग फर्म, ताकि आपकी जो कवरेज है, जो प्रोटेक्शन है, वो बेटर हो. दैट इज कैप्टिव इंश्योरेंस. मूविंग अहेड नाउ टू द नेक्स्ट रिकमेंडेशन. सो IFSCA हैज इनेबल्ड द फ्रेमवर्क फॉर ग्लोबल इनहाउस सेंटर्स विच विल बी यूटिलाइज बाय द इंश्योरर्स टू डेवलप इनहाउस सेंटर्स टू प्रोवाइड एंसिलरी सर्विसेज एंसिलरी टू इंश्योरेंस. सो ग्लोबल इनहाउस सेंटर्स बना लो जो इंश्योरेंस से रिलेटेड जो भी और एंसिलरी सर्विसेज हैं वो भी प्रोवाइड करेंगे. सो ग्लोबली आपको इस एरिया में डेवलप करना है. देन इज इन्वेस्टमेंट फ्रेमवर्क में बी रीडिजाइंड टू गिव मोर अवेन्यूज फॉर इंश्योरर्स टू मोबिलाइज देयर फंड्स टू अ बास्केट ऑफ फाइनेंशियल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एंड प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफरिंग देम मोर रिटर्न्स एंड फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी. सो इन्वेस्टमेंट फ्रेमवर्क को रीडिजाइन किया जाए. देयर इज अ नीड टू रीडिजाइन द इन्वेस्टमेंट फ्रेमवर्क. सी व्हाटएवर फंड्स आर देयर अवेलेबल विद दीज इंश्योरर्स व्हिच दे आर मोबिलाइजिंग, they invested in different financial instruments. So we need to revise the investment framework so that these funds can be invested in better instruments which can help them earn better returns. Then is global premium financing is prevalent, which is very significant drivers for some of the areas of insurance business. Same shall be introduced in IFSC. So IFSC mein hume global premium financing ko introduce karna hai. What is this premium financing? See, we need to make the payment of premiums when we want the protection through the insurance. So we might not be able to pay the premiums. So for that also loans can be provided. Loans to fund your premiums. So premium financing is the lending of funds to a person or a company to cover the cost of insurance premium. Insurance premium aap bhar pao, insurance le pao, protection le pao, uske liye bhi loans milte hain. That is premium financing. Aapko jo premiums pay karne hain, उनको आप फाइनेंस कर रहे हो लोन लेके. इंश्योरेंस प्रीमियम फाइनेंसिंग इज अवेलेबल टू बिजनेसेस दैट नीड असिस्टेंस विद कवरिंग द कॉस्ट ऑफ इंश्योरेंस प्रीमियम. सो जो बड़े बड़े बिजनेस हैं जिन्हें इंश्योरेंस चाहिए लेकिन प्रीमियम की कॉस्ट बहुत ज्यादा है, तो उनको उसके रिलेटेड फंडिंग भी प्रोवाइड की जाती है. सो इंश्योरेंस सेक्टर और डेवलप हो और इसको बूस्ट मिले ग्लोबली, वो इसका ऑब्जेक्टिव है. Then is developing the alternate risk transfer solutions like insurance linked securities, catastrophe bonds. So or risk transferring solutions develop kiye jaye. See, insurance is having a lot of risk associated. If something happens, then you need to pay a lot of claim to the ones who have taken the insurance. So some type of a risk transfer is needed, some type of a risk mitigation is needed. And one such option is to go for catastrophe bonds. So similar kind of solutions need to be developed. अब insurance के business में बहुत ज़्यादा risk है. जिस चीज़ की आपने insurance ली है, अगर वो चीज़ हो जाती है, तो आपको जो भी claim करने वाले हैं, उनको बहुत पैसा देना पड़ता है, जिन्होंने insurance ले रखी है. Suppose you have taken a health insurance, in case of a health issue, you will be provided the claim. In case you have taken some property insurance, then if some harm to that property happens, then you will be compensated for the same. So there is a lot of risk for the insurance company. Now, there is a need to develop various solutions जिसके through ये risks जो है ये कुछ हद तक कम हो पाए. One such option is to go for catastrophe bonds. So हम लोग देख लेते हैं कि catastrophe bonds क्या होते हैं. We also call them the cat bonds. They allow the transfer of risk to the bond investors. See, let's discuss what happens with respect to the catastrophe bonds. Suppose government is issuing these bonds, or there are some insurers or reinsurers who are issuing these bonds. These bonds signify the financial protection in case of a major natural catastrophe such as a hurricane or earthquake. Okay, so when certain kind of a catastrophe will happen, it will help. These bonds will help the insurance companies to have enough funding available to pay the claimants. So, जब कोई कैटास्ट्रॉफी होती है, से कोई नेचुरल डिजास्टर हुआ, अर्थक्वेक आया, हरिकेन आया, उस केस में आप जिसने इंश्योरेंस ले रखी है कोई भी टाइप की, सपोज कोई प्रॉपर्टी इंश्योरेंस ले रखी है और अर्थक्वेक आने से वो प्रॉपर्टी डैमेज हो जाती है, और अग्रीमेंट में था कि कैटास्ट्रॉफी से भी आप प्रोटेक्टेड हो, तो उस केस में कितनी प्रॉपर्टीज डैमेज होंगी, कितने लोगों ने वो इंश्योरेंस ली होगी, तो सबको इंश्योरेंस कंपनी को क्लेम देना पड़ेगा, सबको पैसा देना पड़ेगा. अब इंश्योरेंस कंपनी के पास इतना पैसा कहाँ से आएगा? उन्होंने इतना प्रीमियम नहीं कलेक्ट किया होगा जितना उन्हें पे करना पड़ेगा अगर कोई कैलामिटी आ जाती है. तो इस केस में कैटास्ट्रॉफी बॉन्ड्स बहुत यूजफुल होंगे. insurance company might have given the insurance, say property insurance, to various people where natural calamities, you are getting the protection against natural calamities as well. So once that calamity happens, then the insurance company might have to pay to a lot of claimants, but it might not have earned enough premiums to be able to pay that amount. So catastrophe bonds will be helpful in that case. Let's see how. For the investor, buying the bonds means that they might get higher returns for the investment, not subject to financial market fluctuations. So the catastrophe bonds can be issued, and why investors invest in these bonds? Because they earn good returns, high amount of returns on them. And why the issuer company will issue these bonds? In case a qualifying catastrophe or event occurs, the investors will lose the principal they invested and the issuer will receive the money to cover their losses. अगर जो कैटेस्ट्रॉफी के अगेंस्ट प्रोटेक्शन थी वो कैटेस्ट्रॉफी होती है तो इन्वेस्टर्स को आपको इंटरेस्ट देने की जरूरत, तो अगर कोई कैटेस्ट्रॉफी होती है तो इन्वेस्टर्स को आपको प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट जो उन्होंने इन्वेस्ट किया था वो वापस देने की भी जरूरत नहीं है. वो सारा प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट आप यूज कर सकते हो अपने लॉसेस कवर करने में. सो क्या है, सपोज कोई नेचुरल डिजास्टर है वो नहीं होता तो आप जो है वो इन्वेस्टर को इंटरेस्ट देते रहोगे, इन्वेस्टर को अच्छे रिटर्न्स मिलते रहेंगे तो वो इन्वेस्टेड रहेगा उस बॉन्ड में. अगर कोई कैटेस्ट्रॉफी हो जाती है, ठीक है, तो उस केस में क्या होगा, जो बॉन्ड इश्यूअर है उसको इन्वेस्टर को पूरी प्रिंसिपल वापस करने की जरूरत नहीं है, वो सारा प्रिंसिपल का अमाउंट रख सकते हैं और वो लॉसेस कवर करने में, लोगों के क्लेम्स चुकाने में यूज कर पाएंगे. दैट्स वाई इश्यूअर्स इशू दीज बॉन्ड्स एंड दैट्स वाई इन्वेस्टर टेक इंटरेस्ट इन इन्वेस्टिंग इन दीज बॉन्ड्स. द रीजन इज हाई रिटर्न्स दे गेट. सो इश्यूअर इशू क्यों करता है बॉन्ड्स, व्हाई डज द इश्यूअर इशू दीज बॉन्ड्स, because it protects them against the catastrophes. In case catastrophe happens, they can confiscate the principal amount and use it to recover their losses or use it to pay the claimants. And the investor invests in such catastrophe bonds because they offer higher returns. CAT bonds are also a type of insurance-linked securities. So, ek tarah se insurance-linked security hai. A special purpose vehicle is set up that invests money from investors and pay interest to them. At the end of the term, SP will return the investor's money if a disaster does not happen. And a payout is made to the issuer on the occurrence of the event. Agar wo catastrophe nahi hoti to investors ka paisa unhe wapas mil jayega. Agar hoti hai to wo sara paisa issuer bond ke issuer rakh sakte hain aur wo usko claims dene mein ya apne losses recover karne mein use kar payenge. So these were few terms which I wanted to discuss. Now coming back to our question. Which of these services are provided by IFSC? So they provide fundraising, they provide asset and wealth management, risk management and merger and acquisitions. So all these are there. Answer is option E. Moving to the second question now. It says, identify the kind of insurance in which the parent group creates a licensed insurance company to provide coverage for itself. The main purpose is to avoid using traditional commercial insurance companies having volatile pricing and not meeting specific needs of the company. So we just discussed it's captive insurance. Moving to the next topic and next question of the day. It says, identify the statements incorrectly related to NRE and NRO account. So let's first discuss what is this NRE and NRO account and then we'll come back to this question. So recently what has happened is, Geojit Financial, it has launched a platform where these categories of investors, the non-resident external and the non-resident ordinary, they can open online trading and DMAT services account through Central Repository Services Limited. So there are various NRIs who want to invest in your country. They want to access the securities market. So it was very difficult for them to open the online trading and DMAT account. Now this platform will allow them to open this account in a very short time span easily. So far the brokerages were offering them this facility of trading and DMAT account opening, and it was offered to this NRI account only as a single category. Now it will be offered to both the non-resident external and non-resident ordinary categories of investors. So NRE or NRO account hota kya hai aur isme kaun अपना कैसा मनी होल्ड कर सकता है, व्हाट्स अ एनआरई एंड एनआरओ अकाउंट एंड व्हिच टाइप ऑफ इन्वेस्टर्स कैन होल्ड हाउ मच और व्हिच टाइप ऑफ मनी ओवर हियर, लेट्स डिस्कस दैट. एनआरई अकाउंट व्हिच स्टैंड्स फॉर नॉन रेजिडेंट एक्सटर्नल इज अ बैंक अकाउंट ओपनड इन इंडिया इन द नेम ऑफ एनआरआई टू पार्क हिज फॉरेन अर्निंग्स. सो देयर आर वेरियस एनआरआईज, ओके, they have earnings from different countries and they want to keep that money in India or remit that money to India. So they cannot do so with the normal savings account. If they want to park their foreign earnings, they have to open a NRE account. So NRE account is that account where foreign earnings are held in Indian currency in India. फॉरेन से जो आप पैसा अर्न कर रहे हो उसको इंडिया में अगर आपको रखना है तो इंडियन करेंसी में आपको उसे एनआरई अकाउंट में रखना होता है. देन व्हाट इज अ एनआरओ अकाउंट? द नॉन रेसिडेंट ऑर्डिनरी अकाउंट. इट्स अ बैंक अकाउंट ओपन्ड इन इंडिया इन द नेम ऑफ एनआरआई टू मैनेज द इनकम अर्नड बाय हिम इन इंडिया. सो एनआरई अकाउंट में क्या था, जो आप बाहर से अर्न करते हो पैसा उसको इंडिया में रखना है तो आप इस अकाउंट में रख सकते हो. एनआरओ अकाउंट क्या है? इफ यू आर एन एनआरआई एंड यू आर earning some kind of an income from India only. You are earning some dividend, you are earning some rent, you are earning some interest, some pension, and you want to keep it in India only. So, NRO account is the account where you can keep that money. India mein hi kamaya hua paisa ek NRI ko jab India mein rakhna hai, to wo NRO account mein rakhta hai. Aur foreign mein kamaya hua paisa jab usko India mein rakhna hai, to wo NRE account mein rakhta hai. When your income is earned from some foreign source and you are keeping it in India, the interest earned is tax free. Okay, but if you are earning some income in India, you are an NRI and keeping that money in India, that is in the NRO account, then the interest is taxable. Foreign earnings pe ka interest taxable nahi hai. India mein earnings ka interest jo hai wo taxable hai. Moving ahead now, so NRE and NRO account holders can now open trading and demat account in 5 minutes through this platform. Okay. And how it will benefit? It will enhance the participation by Indian diaspora in the country stock market. So, jo bhi NRIs hai, jo Indian markets mein invest karna chahte hai, unke liye ye process easy ho jayega. This platform is developed as there are many NRIs who are interested in investing in stock market, but they were not doing so due to the delay in the account opening. Okay, now whole process has been eased. Coming back to the question, incorrect statements have to be identified. NRO account is the account of NRI to transfer foreign earnings to India. No, it's NRE account. We just discussed it over here. Then NRE account is account of NRI to manage the income earned in India. No, that's an NRO account. So both of these are incorrect. Interest earned on NRE account is tax free. Yes, this is correct. So first and second are incorrect. Answer is option B. Moving to the next topic and last question of the day. RBI has directed the exclusion of which of the following regional rural banks from the second schedule of the RBI Act. So, as per the RBI Act, we have the scheduled banks also, and we have another category of banks who are not in the list of the second schedule of RBI Act, and we call them the non-scheduled banks. So, let's first discuss what are scheduled and non-scheduled banks, and then we'll come to this notification of RBI. Where RBI has notified that few banks have been excluded from the second schedule of RBI and few have been added to this schedule. Okay, so what are scheduled banks? Banks listed in the second schedule of RBI Act 1934 is a scheduled bank. So RBI ki act ke according second schedule mein jo bhi banks listed hain unko hum scheduled banks kehte hain. इसमें वो सारे बैंक्स आ जाते हैं जिनकी पेड अप कैपिटल, जिनके कलेक्टेड फंड्स 5 लाख या उससे ज्यादा हैं. टू क्वालिफाई एज अ स्केड्यूल्ड बैंक, पेड अप कैपिटल एंड कलेक्टेड फंड्स नीड टू बी मोर देन 5 लाख. ओके, नॉट लेस देन 5 लाख्स. ओनली दोज बैंक्स आर स्केड्यूल्ड बैंक्स. सो व्हाट टाइप्स ऑफ बैंक्स आर कवर्ड ओवर हियर? देयर इज अ लिस्ट ऑफ दी स्केड्यूल्ड बैंक्स. So, scheduled banks includes your SBI and its subsidiaries, nationalized banks, RRBs, foreign banks, private sector banks and some cooperative banks. So, jitte bhi hamare SBI aur uske subsidiaries hai, jitte bhi nationalized banks hai, jitte bhi regional rural banks hai, foreign banks hai, kuch private banks hai, kuch cooperative banks hai, wo sab scheduled banks ke mein aate hain. Basically, unko second schedule of RBI Act mein list kiya gaya hai. Now, what is the benefit of being a scheduled bank? You are eligible to take loans from RBI. See, if you're a scheduled bank, that means you are under the governance of RBI. RBI will govern you. All rules and regulations of RBI you need to adhere. So the customers of such banks are protected. Then these banks need to keep the CRR with RBI, maintain the amount. RBI will also offer them the benefit of taking loans at times of need. Jab bhi bank ki jaise interbank market dry up ho jati hai, banks ko loan ki zarurat hai, to scheduled banks RBI se easily loan le sakte hain. RBI उन्हें रेगुलेट कर रहा है जिस वजह से कस्टमर्स भी प्रोटेक्टेड हैं. रिस्क चिक का लेवल जो है वो कम है विज़वी द नॉन स्केड्यूल्ड बैंक्स. नॉन स्केड्यूल्ड बैंक्स आर दोज विच आर नॉट लिस्टेड इन द सेकंड स्केड्यूल. ओके, द वंस विच हैव अ रिजर्व कैपिटल ऑफ लेस देन 5 लाख क्वालिफाई टू बी नॉन स्केड्यूल्ड बैंक्स. So, like, unlike scheduled banks, they are not entitled to borrow from RBI in normal business purpose, except in emergency and abnormal circumstances. So, just like scheduled banks were offered the benefit of taking loans from RBI for normal business purpose, that benefit is not there for non-scheduled banks. वो अपनी मर्जी से normal banking purpose के लिए RBI से loan नहीं ले सकते. Although, exceptional cases में कोई emergency है, कोई abnormal circumstance है, तब इनको RBI loan दे देगा, otherwise not. So, local area banks like Coastal Local Area Bank, Capital Local Area Bank, they are some of the examples of the non-scheduled banks. So, what's the latest notification of RBI? RBI has directed the exclusion of 3 banks from second schedule. They include Baroda Uttar Pradesh Grameen Bank, Kashi Gomti Samyun Grameen Bank and Purvanchal Bank. Ye tino banks ko second schedule se exclude karne ka direction diya hai RBI ne. And one bank needs to be included, that is Baroda UP Bank of Gorakhpur, Uttar Pradesh. So, ye bank include ho gaya hai second schedule mein aur in teeno ko remove karne ki baat ki gayi hai. So, we move back to the question, which of these is, has RBI has directed the exclusion of which of these banks? So, first three, right? Answer is option C. This was all for today's session. With this, I would like to end up this session. Thank you so much.